outside the beach ballroom, ready for WrestleZone Aberdeen Anarchy. I've already met Billy Gunn and Hacksaw Jim Duggan, and they were fantastic. Really nice guys. I had a million questions, was so starstruck, all I could mutter out was "Big fan!" So it's going to be a great show. It starts 45 minutes, where you get the, because I'm VIP, again at 5 o'clock, along with the other VIPs, and we'll get to meet some of the stars. Hopefully I'll get to meet Kaylee Ray, because that's who I want to see. That's just the favourite I want to see. I've met Johnny Lyons a few times from SWN shows, so it'd be great to see him again, and meet the rest of the guys. And yeah, it's going to be a good show.
Good about it.
Hello and welcome to a very special edition of the SWN Podcast. I am your host, as always, Billy, and it's episode 150. I'm so excited for you to see this. We've done something different for episode 150 because it's a milestone episode. And what we've done is it's Billy's Aberdeen Anarchy road trip. So I went to Aberdeen this past Saturday and went to see Aberdeen Anarchy. And that's it. That's pretty much the premise of the episode. Some things went well, some things did not with my plannings and recordings, but we had a really good time, and I hope you enjoy what's going to come for the next, I don't know, half an hour or so. Before we go any further, just a quick plug, because I am blatantly stealing one of the Mickey's Mosh Pitch episodes when he does backstage stuff at shows and that. So I'm going to plug his t-shirt, which you can see here, a little bit of Mosh Pit Mondays world tour, and it's also mainly because it's got my name on the back, which I'll turn around and show you. Hope you can see that, and it's not just all my arse that's in your screen there. So this would be, I mean, listen to the audio version, it'll be ace, but to really get everything that I'm putting out in this episode, probably head to YouTube. If you can, if you're listening to the audio version, YouTube will be your friend, because I'll have some clips, I'll have there's a montage, and if you stick around long enough, there's even a slideshow. So I'm going to pop in near the end for the outro, but enjoy the episode. Hello and welcome to a very special edition of the SWN podcast, featuring mostly my steering wheel at this point in time. This is the special 150th episode of the SWN podcast, and it's a road trip episode. Woo, yay! So I'm heading to WrestleZone Aberdeen Anarchy today. It's at the Northern Hotel in Aberdeen. I'm going to have a lot of fun. There's 10 matches announced on the show. And yeah, it's going to be ace. We did a preview show with Kyle on the Wrestle Ropes podcast that went out on Thursday. No doubt we'll have some reviews up by Adam and what have you. So there's a lot of stuff we'll be doing all related to Aberdeen Anarchy. I did have major plans minor plans of doing some stat stuff. I did that on Twitter a little bit, so that's where that ended up going. But I'm really excited about Aberdeen Anarchy because it is the best show of the year. Now, usually, I know Vago did something very similar to this for his episodes, and I'm sure he put a phone on a mount up on his dash. But weirdly, a Sandero, a Dasha Sandero, does not have the things to do the air, the air blower things aren't really great for putting a mount on. So unfortunately, you're stuck in front of, tell me what speed I'm going, the old dash thing there. So you may see my face, you may not occasionally, because I'm quite a wildly cornery driver. So I'm really excited for the show, because this will probably be a shorter episode of the podcast, because it's mostly going to be me talking. It's going to be a weird audio, a weird video experience for you, because you won't be able to see my face all so much. But once I get to Aberdeen, we'll do a little bit more recording, and hopefully I'll be able to find a couple guys. Hopefully we'll be able to speak to Kyle, maybe even Kayleigh of the K&K Wrestle Factory. I'll be speaking to them, and grab some folk in the queue as well that enjoy the podcast, and they'll get to go on. I might cut some footage during the show, just a little snippet and clips, nothing that'll really give away much of the show itself, because that's not fair for me to do that, because it's that whole thing, is that you don't want to record loads of stuff and then put it out there, because WrestleZone will put this out on DVD, they'll put out Aberdeen Anarchy on DVD, so I'll get some clips and then splice them throughout the episode. And I'm looking forward to it. It's not often I go to a wrestling show on my own now, especially in Aberdeen, because usually Kelly comes with me, but she is off to Inverness to go do some baby shopping instead. Obviously for clothes, not for actual babies. We've got one ordered. It's on its way. It should be here by the end of August. So she's left me to do that, and I am going all the way to Aberdeen Anarchy by myself. I hate driving in Aberdeen, but thankfully I'm still in Elgin as I'm recording. So yeah, so the show itself, there's 10 matches on the card. Things have changed at the last minute. We've got two pre-show matches with Air Miles against Alistair Caron, and we've also got Blue Thunder versus Rhys Dawkins. I'm looking forward to both the matches. Like I said in the preview on the Wrestle Ropes podcast with Kyle, this whole card is going to be ace. It's just, there's going to be a lot of surprises, a lot of fun. The big thing that happened this morning, as of recording, is that Captain Alan Sterling, toot, has got COVID. He's tested positive for COVID, so he won't be in the match with Caleb Valhalla over the Tri-Counties Championship, which I'm gutted by. I'm gutted that's the case, because it's just seeing Caleb finally get revenge on Alan was going to be absolutely incredible. But it's not to be, so that'll probably be Battle of the Nations that'll happen. So I've no idea what's going to happen tonight when it comes to Caleb, whether they're going to find someone else to go and face Caleb. Who knows, maybe he'll defend the Fair City Wrestling Heavyweight Championship. Why not? Anything can happen at Aberdeen Anarchy Day. So yeah, a lot is going to happen tonight, and hopefully I'm going to capture some of it. Like I said, this will probably be a shorter episode of the podcast, but I really want to do something different to celebrate 150 episodes of the SWN podcast, because it's been great to do this, because the pandemic happened. This started when the pandemic properly started. This was June. I got the first recording in with Omar Muhammad, and since then it's really been a great way for me to get some stories of some of the new names you may not know of, maybe some wrestlers that have been restricting themselves just to one company or to one area, and you get to find out a little bit more about them. So it's been a great journey. It's been a lot of fun to do, and it's been a wonderful experience. But so 150 episodes in, I think I've got about mentally, I think about 15 more episodes after it, and then that's season 4 complete. And that'll actually be the end of the podcast for a little bit as well, because I will be taking a hiatus, to become a dad and buy all that wrestling stuff for him, for this future child, future wrestler. I'm already waiting 14 years so I can enroll them into wrestling training, and I can live out my dreams through them. I'm looking forward to today. I'm looking forward to just the whole experience, and I'm looking forward to sharing it with you guys as well through the podcast. Hopefully you can hear me, because I've never really recorded in my car before. And like I say, I did buy a magnet and everything to try and put my phone on so you could actually see my face a little bit better, but that's just absolutely shite. It's not worked. My phone keeps falling off. So instead, you're getting me looking over you like I'm like going to beat you down or something. But hopefully the audio is okay as well. Well, I'll find out on Sunday, when I inevitably do a little bit of a post-show segment as well. So the plan is this bit for a couple minutes. Then we're going to get to Aberdeen, record maybe a couple more minutes. Go into the queue, a couple more minutes there. interval, a couple more minutes, and then, so if it gets to about half an hour, I'll be quite happy with the length of the episode, but we'll just have to wait and see. So I think I'm going to sign off at this point. I'm going to go around this roundabout first. I'm just out of Elgin, for those that are absolutely interested, and just going past Lumbride. And we're going to be in Aberdeen in about an hour and a bit, depending on traffic and depending on if I have an absolute meltdown, which is 100% possible when it comes to driving in Aberdeen, because I absolutely hate it. So if I don't make it there, I love you. I'm just kidding. I'll see you soon. Enjoy. We have made it to the infamous Northern Hotel in Aberdeen. Only got lost once, so that's nice. I'm way too early though, because it's like 12, half 12, 1 o'clock, something like that. So I am going to go and get food. But I'm so excited for this show tonight. I'm probably going to say that a few times in this very short episode. But I'm excited. There's 8 matches on the main card, including the main event, of course, being Damien Zach Dynamite and Aspen Faith. I am repping Aspen Faith. I'll show you if I can... Oh no, I have no idea how to flip this camera, because my technology is terrible. Oh, there's a bus. Cool. Right, so I'm going to go and find some food. So stay tuned. This is a riveting... oh, yeah, some regulars. Hey. this is a riveting road trip episode. Again, I hope you're still kind of enjoying it and into it. But, right, let's go find some food. So we've made it to Aberdeen nice and safely. Went past the Northern, as you saw in the last bit. And now I'm just hanging out at the beach like a big old creep. Picked up some food, probably pick up some more before I leave. But I'm it's just hype. Today is hype, all hype. So the rest of the card, it was like I really mentioned it. The first bit I said about the pre-show matches. So the show tonight, I mean, we've got Crowbar versus Chris Archer. That should be a good bit of fun. We've got the six man, we've got Omar Muhammad, Scotty Swift, and a mystery partner against the outfit of William Sterling. Great. Kill Valhalla against a, don't know what he's doing, mystery opponent. Maybe he's going to be the third man instead. We're going to have a 9-match card. I've no idea. So we're going to find out the answer to that. We've got the tag titles on the line when Connor and Crusher defend against the Foundation of the Future. And like I mentioned, the big main event as well between Aspen Faith, Damien, the champion, and Zach Dynamite. Probably forgotten a match, and I'm gonna feel like a right dick about it as well. So it's a big card, big show, Northern Hotel. I'm hopefully I'm not jinxing it by drinking a gold edition of Monster. Apparently it's pineapple. Quite like pineapple. Let's have a taste. That's for your audio listeners. It's all right. It's weird. I don't like pineapple, but I like pineapple flavored things. That's just part of my life. So yeah, 149 interviews ish, because we did that weird episode where I got interviewed by Brett Carter for episode 100. But 149 interviews, we'll say. And I've had a whale of a time, because I've said in many episodes that I worked from home in March 2020, and I started the podcast June 2020, and this is my way of just interacting with people, because in real life, as you probably will see when I try to do content like in the queue and that, I am a very awkward person. So that'll just be a bit weird and a bit awkward for everyone involved, including you, the viewer at home. So this will be a nice way for me to interact, be a bit social. I also think it's been, I think I may have made some friends as well. God forbid, I've made some friends. So it's been nice. So what's next? I have no idea. I'm now just sitting in the car park at the beach, at the Queen's Links. There's a Burger King over there. There's a Range over there. I don't have enough time to go to the cinema to see Doctor Strange again. That'd be weird. Go for a wee explore. Maybe I'll load up. We'll get some footage of the beach ballroom before I go. That's what we'll do. A legendary venue. So there's probably some wrestling footage of some description next, and then I'll probably be outside the beach ballroom. See you in a sec.
Oh! nice a monster to make an Aspen Faith edition of their cans for his impending victory tonight. I hope.
I missed loads of matches in that last bit. I forgot Vago and Ronan King in a Singapore cane match, which is going to be brutal. Evan Young against Brian Tucker as well. We've got the old Johnny Lyons, tenacious Johnny Lyons back. I am getting to the beach ball room. I'm still drinking my monster. I also forgot Mr. P and Sean Johnson against Luke King, Sharp and Krieger. The winner will go on to face the tag team champions at Battle of the Nations, which I actually already have my ticket for, being one of the lucky people that bought a weekend ticket and just didn't ask for a refund. I got a pre-sale code and I've got a ticket for Battle of Nations. So whether I go, that is a different matter, but I've got my ticket anyway, just in case, just on off chance that I can get there when that is due to take place. So, right, I am going now. I'm going over, and then we'll get some footage of the beach ballroom. I might do some pointing, even though Aberdeen Anarchy is not taking place there. It did take place there for a number of years, but I'll speak about that when I get there. Right, I'm going. I'm definitely going this time. Ooh.
Here I am outside, and there is the beach ballroom in the background. It has been like 9 years since I did this kind of video from before my first ever WrestleZone show. And here we are, back to the beach ballroom. So I think I put a video right at the start of the episode with me at a very sprightly 22 years old, cameo, 22 years old, right about the same spot, and being so excited to see Kaylee Ray and say fantastic too many times. And yeah, all these years later, 9 years later, back outside again. So
let's see if we get
a little bit closer, maybe get some video, because we'll also visit the 2019 venue, because Beach Ballroom held the Aberdeen Anarchy event 2013 to 2018, and it had some amazing matches, moments and wrestlers. First one, of course, having Billy Gunn and Hacksaw Jim Duggan. And then bigger names, biggest, better names, if you could even imagine it, came. Like Hornswoggle, Pac came to the Leisure Centre in 2019, and had Tatanka. We've also had the best matches in WrestleZone history, including Stevie Boy Xavier against Bingo Balance in the 2013 event. It's a really historic venue. It's just a shame that, for whatever reason, they haven't went back there. Maybe one day we'll get an air show back at the Beach Ballroom for so many epic moments again. But tonight is the Northern Hotel, and it's a whole different beast when it comes to moments and everything in between. It's an excellent venue. It's a rowdy venue, it's a hot venue, so that's why I'm shorting up. But let's get a little bit closer. Beautiful venue. Don't know what's going on today, but it's not going to be as good as WrestleZone Aberdeen Anarchy. I'll tell you that for free. It's ace. Yeah, again, moments that have happened at Aberdeen Anarchy at this venue. Things like Aspen Faith winning the Tri-Counties Championship for the first time when they were determining the first champion. We've had moments like, I'm so unfit, I'm realising now. We've had such great moments. It was there for so long, 2013 to 2018, and it just gave everyone a glimpse of what WrestleZone is, can do, and then that set you up for the year. So you can go back, you can go their next show, wherever it is, in Viruri, and you'll go there because you saw this show, and then you're hooked forever. Let's go right back to the Beach Life Centre. There's the Star Ballroom. That's where we do our meet and greets. That's where I first met Billy Gunn and Hacksaw Jim Duggan, and all the guests between then and 2018, including a really random one with Jeannie Clark. Of course, Steve Austin's first wife, or manager at some point. So, a little bit of history. Awesome. And right next door is the Beach Leisure Centre. It was a 2019 Aberdeen Anarchy event, it was here, Baltic venue. But it's also had hosted Christmas Chaos Comes Early with Mick Foley, Battle of Nations, the year we had Andy Wilde against Drew Galloway. It's really a great place. Cold though. Definitely cold. If I remember rightly when I was doing the meet and greet with McFoley, shit ton of stairs.
It's still cool, maybe.
Nonetheless. So yeah, last. This is where Damien won his championship as well in 2019. Now when he defeated Brutal Lightning and became Undisputed WrestleZone champion. So this is where the last Aberdeen Anarchy was held. The next one is tonight, as of recording, at an Arnold Hotel. As you can tell, I can't bloody wait. That was Aberdeen Anarchy. I tried to get some footage in the queue and in the venue talking, but it was so loud tonight I just could not get anything recorded. Outside the venue tonight, next to our road, so that was just going absolutely nuts. But I did get some footage, so I'm going to play some a little bit before this, and then I'm going to play a very much out of context montage after this. To complete this episode, I suppose this like I say, quite shorter episode. We'll do a little bit of a review of sorts tomorrow morning when my throat may have recovered and I've had a little bit of a kip. I have got a Domino's pizza, so that'll keep me going for the drive home. It was an incredible show, absolutely amazing. It was quite an emotional night. Start of the show, after the tag team title match, Crusher Crabe announced his retirement. And we ended the show with the Foundation of the Future with all the belts. So I am emotionally spent, and I am going to go home, have some pizza, maybe have a little cry, because it was just an amazing night. I know that this podcast and most of my stories and experiences, it's really kind of WrestleZone centric, and being up in the Northeast, that's the promotion I get to the most frequently, and they always make it worth going. Tonight there were some incidents which probably definitely didn't go to plan. There was a guitar flying into the crowd. There was mishaps, I suppose. But the emotion of the show and the crowd and the wrestlers, it made it all just wonderful. Even though the main event was Hasak Dynamite win, of course that was my logical choice, but not not what my heart wanted. I'd asked him to win, of course, but it was a phenomenal match, a phenomenal night. It was just I'm actually getting emotional now, and this is what, maybe the show finished 20 minutes ago, because I'm still in the car park outside the Northern Hotel. It's one of those companies that just make it worthwhile, you know. I've been lucky to, I put up on Twitter, I've interviewed about 20 of the guys that were on tonight's show, and they were just, they all knocked out the park. Everyone put on a great match. Just to throw out, just off the top of my head mentions, Crusher, of course, because this was his last match. I spoke to him after the show as well, and then he's pretty upset that's his last wrestling match. He might come back for some appearances or bits and pieces here, but that's him done. That whole tag team match was amazing. Like I said, a piece of footage, little snippets. I've dotted about this episode, whether it's in the montage or beforehand. I don't want to put in too much, because of course it is WrestleZone property, and I don't want to give away too much of the show, because they'll put out on DVD. Hopefully they'll put maybe some footage out as well. It's a really special company to me, and
They've been really kind to me when they don't need to be. I'm a guy with a blog. I'm a guy with a website because I really love Scottish wrestling, and they allow me to just enjoy it the way I want to enjoy it. Whether it's I'm not a really emotive person when it comes to shows, and that's they're happy. They've no issues with that. I speak to them. They've been very welcoming with the work that we do. Myself, Kyle, Adam, especially Adam. They're very, very accommodative with what we do. They've really helped me through many things. Through breakups, I suppose. It's through death as well. I mean, like, I don't know if this will underplay other people's, because of course any death is bad, but like, say I went to a show the weekend my dog was put down, and that was just the hardest, probably one of the hardest weekends of my life. Saying that, that means I'm very blessed in that respect. And the guys, they just provided an outlet, a show, just a couple hours where I could switch off and enjoy. I didn't really expect to get as emotional as I have at this particular event. I mean, I expected to get emotional in the main event. That was a given, because it was a triple threat. It was Aspen. He's a guy that's been a firm favourite of mine since pretty much the start of my WrestleZone journey in 2013. I loved his look. I loved everything about him. So he's just incredible as a wrestler, and I just enjoy watching him wrestle and his character and what have you. And to see Damien as well, he's provided an amazing story. And even though I'm sad that he carried that company, even out with when no shows could happen, he was still the champion, and he still presented himself as a champion. He wasn't involved in any of this shit that happened in 2020. He just carried himself well, and he was a worthy champion. And Zach is, like I say, it was a logical choice. He earned it all the way. He reinvented himself, and he made himself just undeniable as the champion as well. So wow, I am spent. I'm emotionally spent. My pizza's getting colder. So I think I'm gonna just leave it at that, and I am gonna drive home. So there'll be a little bit of montage. There'll be a bit of out of context WrestleZone shenanigans. I know this is the 150th podcast about SWN Podcast, and this is probably more akin to a Wrestle Ropes podcast, but once I stop the podcast the 1st of July, I probably won't get to maybe one or two shows I'll get to after that, and then I'm starting a family, and the podcast will go away, the website will stay. I will keep it as updated as I possibly can with the time that I have. It might just be results. It might be the odd announcement. It'll be different. And I want to thank everyone as well that listens to all these podcasts. Like I said, it's 150. That's not counting Wrestle Ropes ones. That's not counting the Untitled ones. It's not counting the Sharp Dojo series, which Looking Sharp was kind enough to ask me to do. And it's been a wonderful experience. As someone who is very anxious in settings with just people in general and interacting with people, it's allowed me to get to know you guys as wrestlers, get to know people that has listened to the podcast through feedback and what have you. And I've had a wonderful time. I've got 15 episodes left of the SWN podcast, and I plan to make them the best podcasts I could possibly do. And I'm doing that because not just because I enjoy making the podcast. I like to think that you enjoy listening to it. Whether I get 5 listens for a particular episode, whether I get 50, I don't care. If one person's listened to an episode, that is enough for me. Really is truly enough for me. Because I enjoy putting wrestler stories out there for you to enjoy and for you to listen to. Anyway, I'm just rambling now. So I'll probably do a little bit like montage next. And I might do a little bit once I have woken up tomorrow morning with a wrestling hangover, which is always the healthiest and the best ones. Right. We're back to Helgen then. Great.
An episode. Am I right, guys? That was a lot of fun to do. We do have some questions for this little outro segment, which I'm going to answer before we head off. But thank you just WrestleZone for putting on a fantastic show. Thanks to Kyle and Kayleigh for making sure I'm not Billy No Mates the whole time and just having a grand old time. So we do have some questions, and we've got, let's find it now, which would have been a good idea to have.
We've got Ronan King, of course. You saw a little bit of a clip of him with his mosh pit gear on earlier on. He's asked, how amazing was it to see that guitar get smashed all over Vago's head? It was incredible, incredible visual, seeing as I was at the corner it happened. Probably not so amazing for the girl that ended up getting the guitar smashed against her elbow when you threw it behind you, Ronan. You know, you're starting to develop a reputation here for being a bit of a danger in front of a live audience. But it was a tremendous guitar shot at the end of the day. We've got more questions here. We've got Callum. We've got loads of questions. Does Aspen get his revenge? Fingers crossed. Battle of the Nations coming up August 6th. So fingers crossed that that is the case. We get maybe a rematch, triple threat, or maybe just a one-on-one. Who knows? Maybe a triple threat. I'd like to see it run it back, get Damon his rematch in there as well, and just run it back for Battle of the Nations. It's due to be at the Northern, so I'm not expecting a cage, but maybe some sort of stipulation in there. Lumberjacks, why not? Do something cool. Did the main event go a little more attitude than family friendly? Perhaps. There was a lot of chair shots towards the end of the match itself. And of course, the chair being the difference maker at the end as well. But Damien got leathered with it. So it went a little bit crazy, a little bit wild, but that's what they've been doing since they came back. When we saw Halloween hijinks, it was really brawly and quite just starting to just get a little bit of an edge going on about it. And that's kind of been built up. So you've been kind of accustomed to it. You've been kind of get like this is probably how we're going to do a little bit of some things, some more heated rivalries. We're going to be a little bit more a bit more just hard hitting, but it's still a death match as our show. I don't know if you saw that on Twitter. Jesus. When do we see the Fair City Saints up in Aberdeen? As soon as possible. We've already seen Air Miles. We've seen Alex Webb. I've seen them both in singles action. Why not? They're a good team. They're a really family orientated, family friendly team as well. And we need more tag teams because, of course, Crusher Crabe has unfortunately retired. So he's retired and that means one team's gone. I think all we've got left is the Outfit and the Champions, of course, Foundation of the Future, Sean and Mr. P. And then if Luke King, Sharp and Krieger keep coming up, that'd be ace because I will never say no to that. But there's a lot. We need some more teams. We just need some more teams. And Fair City Saints against the Foundation of the Future. Oof, yeah, I'm all in for that. What's next for Malloy? Tri-Counties. I don't know how, because Caleb and Alan are on this collision course, but I can see Malloy and if Dynamite retains the Battle of Nations, I can see him and Dynamite and Malloy have an absolute fantastic match, an absolute incredible match. So there's plenty, there's only ways up for Conor Malloy. Is Caleb going to kill the captain? Yes. That's it. Unfortunately, Captain Alan was COVID positive on the day, so he couldn't go. Sad toot in the chat. But he's going to die soon. He's just now holding off the inevitable. And finally, when is the SWN boys going to get a match against the Foundation of the Future? Never, because I am terrified by them. Especially after the post show. I don't know if I said it in the previous bit, but I've said numerous occasions I am not good with people interaction and wrestler interaction. And to have Zach and Brad shoving their respective belts in my face and asking if I was going to cry, I was. That's enough for me. That's fine. I just unlike Ricky Bobby when he's doing the adverts, he doesn't know what he wants to do with his hands. He's like, do my hands. I'm just standing there going, I don't know what to do here. Do I cry? Do I smile? I'm going to cry, but you know, I don't want to make that the only option in my arsenal here. So yeah, I'm quite happy never to do that. I will just continue to watch if that's not an issue. And finally, Kyle Watt, of course, of K&K Wrestle Factory. Thank you again to Kyle and Kaylee because they were just ace and everyone that was there. He's asked, when would you like the first Aspen Faith fan support group meeting to take place? You know what? I don't know. When are you doing the next Wrestle Factory? I think that's probably when it's going to be, as me and you have a wee cry and Kaylee sits in the corner going, guys, it's just, come on. This is probably, this is a bit sad now. It's a sad occasion because, you know, Aspen lost. But yeah, it was an amazing night. Thank you for everyone who put in questions for me to yobble on and ramble about to make this episode a little bit longer for episode 150. I said in the intro, I showed you my Mickey's Mosh Pit t-shirt. You can go get it now. You can go message him at Mickey, I think it's at Mickey Vago. Hang on. Because, you know, a professional would have. Yeah, at Mickey Vago on Twitter. Jump into his DMs, order a t-shirt, £15 plus postage. Bargain. And you get a t-shirt with my name on it, which is the coolest thing in the world. I've keep saying it because it's just crazy to me that there's a wrestling t-shirt being sold at shows with my name on it. That just blows my mind entirely. So that's it. Episode 150 in the books, in the pocket, out of sight. We've got like I said, 15 more episodes to do. I think I'm recording three this week, two the week after, and then that's giving me a little bit of a buffer space. I'll go organize only like five more, and then that's it. All done. Season four is done, and that's the podcast on hiatus. I might do some limited episodes throughout the year, but as far as a two a week or one a week, that'll be it. That's it. So July 1st will be the culmination of that. So I hope you enjoyed this episode. I really hope you do, because I that montage, that little montage of clips was my favorite thing to make, and I actually had a wee tear in my eye when I watched it back. I'm just hoping that Windows Movie Maker actually lets me do it, and it's not going to just be black screens every couple seconds, because I'm so proud of that montage. So you can follow us at Scott Resnett on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram as well. My voice is still not totally recovered from the weekend because of all the shouting. But no, once again, I just thank you to everyone who's listened. Thank you to WrestleZone for providing an amazing show for me to do a little road trip episode on. And just, yeah, I've had a good time. And hopefully I'll get to Battle of Nations. But if not, that's the last WrestleZone show I see for a while. It was absolutely worth it. So have a good one, folks.